السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. During حلمية time from 1950 to 1963, I was also affected by the surrounding of the atmosphere and the culture of the city and the culture of the country at that time. And this is a lesson to all of you parents, actually, to see what will impact the growing character of your young children. Some of them were actually movie stars. Because we used to have an excellent and top movie stars in Egypt at the time. I will just mention a few of them. I don't think every one of you will know them, but actually those people were top movie stars, like what we used to see in the American movies in the 50s and 40s, in the British movies in the 50s and 40s, like actually, and in the 60s, even the drama, and actually how people loved the profession of acting in front of the camera. So they produced a great movies which we are still enjoying them nowadays. I can't remember a lot of them, by Scrooge and Tale of Two Cities and Oliver Twist and others in English. But in Arabic, the names of the artists, I'm not sure if you'll be able to know all of them, but I just mentioned some of them: Mohsin Sirhan, Amin Rezli, Firdaus Muhammad, and other people. Those people, when they act from their heart, because they used to live the character when they are in front of the camera, they impacted me positively and negatively. Understand the difference between the good man and the bad man, the evil and the goodness, and the kindness and the love and the care and all those sort of things. Singers, Egypt at that time has a plethora of top singers. Most of you might know somebody like Muhammad Abdul Wahab, Umm Kulthum, Farid Al-Atrash, Abd al-Halim Hafiz, Muhammad Rushdie, Muhammad Abdul. People nowadays, especially Fairuz, which is still alive, Faiz Ahmad, Wadi' al-Safi from Lebanon, Fahd Balam from Lebanon, Nagah Salam from Lebanon, Walid al-Jazariya from Algeria, and so on and so on. But at that time, the strength of the voice or the vocal cord of the singer make him a top singer. Then they used to know how to recite poetry, how to understand the levels of music and the different music that they can sing, because they were singing from their heart. They loved the poetry, they loved the music, and they loved to meet the people and let them to enjoy the singing. Many of them, unfortunately, we don't have some of this nowadays. Composers, actually, like Muhammad Abdul Wahab also, Farid Atrash, Kamal Al-Tawir, Red Sumbati, Al-Mughi and Al-Asab. They wrote an excellent pieces of music for the singers to sing at that time. And that's why whenever we use to listen to these songs or to those songs nowadays, we go back with love and care and emotion to the good old days. Even the authors and the writers, such as Taha Hussein, is an international figure, Najib Mahfouz, who was a Nobel Peace Prize winner, Ihsan Abdul Quddus, Abbas Aqad, a great author, and as well as Tawfiq Al-Hakim, Yusuf Al-Sibani, Yusuf Idris. When you read their books, whether it's a novel or a drama or whatever you call it, you live through the way they wrote and the metaphor and the wealth of the knowledge in how to understand Arabic language and how to imagine the scenes and the scenario and the dialogue between people in the drama. You find it's not there anymore, unfortunately. People who recite Quran, reciters, Qari, I think most of you will know what the names what I'm mentioning it. Sheikh Al-Husari, Rahmatullah Ali, Sheikh Muhammad Rifat, Rahmatullah Ali, Sheikh Sharabasi, Sheikh Abbas Abdul Samad, Sheikh Al-Minshawi, Sheikh Al-Banna, Sheikh Mustafa Ismail, Sheikh Sha'isha as well. And as many. And when you look at all those, even when they recite Quran, they can imagine the scenes inside the verses of the Quran, whether in heaven or hellfire, on the goodness and the good news and the bad news to come to the evil people in this. They live the Quran when they recite the Quran. That's why we cannot forget the way they used to recite Quran. Presenters on television, I don't think you know most of them, but actually they used to understand the Arabic language and the phonation of the Arabic language. and how to attract you to them when they are actually talking to you through the radio, through the television, or through any other means in the recording at that time. There was no recording at that time. The theater as well, the theater was great actors and directors and people there, and people used to sit down and enjoy in politeness. When people used to, in the theater, nobody talks while the theater, the act is playing by actually the artists. Even football, the quality of the game, the people, the manner, the relationship, because each football player loved to play football at that time. They were not coming for the money. There was no professional, something called professional football players. Everyone, and for the club to discover the young talented football player from the countryside, they have to travel the country and go to the small areas at the backyard of Cairo to see those young players who used to play the sock football at that time. If I mention the names, I don't think you will know them. The scholars, some of you might know some of them nowadays, like Sheikh Sha'rawi, Rahmatullah Alayh, Sheikh Abd al-Hamid Kishk, Sheikh Al-Ghazali, Sheikh Shaltut, Sheikh Muhammad Bakhouri, Sheikh Muhammad Madni, Dr. Abd al-Aziz Kamel, and others. When we look at all them, we find that those people very well learned, very well educated, very well people who are actually have got a high level of ability to understand the community and to reflect and to the community and see what were the needs of the community at that time, whether actually on the drama or the cinema or in the singing or in the music or in actually recitation of the Quran and writing the novels and others. Well, I feel sorry nowadays because of the advancement of technology that actually this kind of music, this kind of movies become very technical, no spirit in it. That's why our children, grandchildren, are much deprived from the real taste of art inside the profession that actually they are listening, they are watching, or they are actually talking about. That's why I was very much affected by these kind of incredible individuals at my childhood. Thank you very much for watching the video, and if you like it, please share it with your actually friends and colleagues. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.